Hey, this is Luke with Salt Strong. Today we're going to be doing a review of this Cranka Crab lure. This has been the top recommended lure after we did a couple prior reviews of other crabs. So I'll just go and show those to you right now. So one was this one from Chasebaits, and the other was Savage Gear. And so again, many people mentioned to check these out, and so I went ahead and bought one. And so I'll talk about the pros and the cons just on the first look. And because right now it's not sheepshead time. Sheepshead season is really best in the winter time. And so I'll be using this this coming up winter, and I'll be doing a detailed review on exactly which one catches the most fish. But I think just from looking at this and seeing it up close, I can at least help you make a wise decision on which crabs to go for. So let me go ahead and open this up, and we'll see what it looks like. All right, so here is the lure. Here it is, and what's unique on this one is that this is hard. So this is, it's basically like a hard plastic, so this will definitely not, the pro is that this will definitely not get torn into bits if pufferfish come around. These legs, they're a really hard plastic. Definitely much firmer plastic than these other crabs. And the other unique thing is that these claws are actually made, you know, they look pretty real. Not as real as what I was expecting, but they're actually made of some stuff that floats, of foam. And so basically what happens is that when this crab is on the ground, these little claws are floating up top, which makes it look more realistic. So that's pretty cool. And so the other pro I would say is just how lifelike this looks. I mean, this does have a pretty good paint job, right? You just look at it, it looks like a real crab. So I definitely, as far as the realistic look, this has it, right? It does look nice. And, but you know, obviously there's no perfect lure. So let's talk about the cons. And this, there's actually a lot of cons that I see, especially after using some of these other crabs. Number one, is let's just talk about, we'll leave price towards the end because that's really the biggest one. But as far as their performance, what at least what I believe the performance will be is that, you know, sheep's head fishing, at least the type of fishing that I do, sheep's head are very structure oriented. They're hanging around dock pilings, they hang around rocks, they hang around a lot of hard structure. And so having treble hooks down there near all that structure, especially with a very expensive lure that we'll talk about price later, to me, that sounds like a bad idea. That sounds like a significant risk of getting snagged on the bottom and losing around like $14 what this thing costs. So for that, as far as the performance, I would be very hesitant to cast an expensive lure like this near the spots that actually hold the most sheep's head. So that performance-wise, the trebles I'm not a fan of. Even for unhooking fish, even for just personal safety and just releasing a fish that's either not too big, I really am not a fan of trebles. I don't use them really at all anymore, and so that aspect I'm definitely not a fan of. And so as far as realism, I mean, yes, this one does look real, but so do the others, right? So this is the one by Chasebaits, looks very real. These are two different sizes. Chasebaits makes a bigger one of these, but it looks real, and right, and both of them have in the water, their little claws are shaking and everything. I mean, these lures, both of them look ultra real. The big difference is price. This one is much less expensive than the other. And so the other con is the actual legs. So these legs really don't do anything. They're really hard. You can see I can shake it and they're not moving at all. Whereas these, I can barely shake it. And even those legs are fluttering. So this crab lure, if you see that review, and if you haven't seen it, I'll put a link down below, but this lure is excellent for the drop. Because as the lure is dropping, these legs are shimmering. It looks just like a live crab. So this is the one, as far as the back of the reviews, this one, this Chasebaits does the best on dropping down a piling. Those sheep's head will bite it as it drops. And then for dragging on the bottom, this Savage Gear crab has the leg up because it sits on the bottom and these claws are sitting up like a defensive position, right? So that you're pulling it away from the sheep's head, and it looks like that crab is trying to retreat from the sheep's head or whatever you're trying to catch. Sheep's head, grouper eat these, snapper, I've got snapper, grouper, snook, pretty much everything will eat a crab. And that's really the premise of this. That's why they have these foam claws, is so that when you're dragging it, right, it's hooked on the back, so you're dragging it away and those claws are sticking up, that was their way of getting that. So if you're dragging a lure, you know, this Savage Gear Crab, which is the least expensive of all, that does a great job. And then if you're dropping down pilings, this would be the way to go, in my opinion. So as far as the overall price, we'll just talk about price now so that we can talk about all three relative to the price. So this Savage Gear Crab, I got on Amazon. They're hard to find, so I had to get it on Amazon. None of the local stores had them. And it was $12 to $14, somewhere in that range. I haven't seen these anywhere less than $12, at least when I was looking at it. So very, very expensive lure, and that's for one. So that's one lure, $12, that you're casting near structure with treble hooks. So that alone is a significant con, in my opinion. And then we were talking about these other ones. This one from Chasebaits is two for $8, so we're talking $4 a pop. And then these from Savage Gear are two for like $5, maybe $5 or $6. So significant price difference from these compared to this Cranka Crab. So long story short, again, I haven't yet used this, so I can't say for certain whether it'll significantly outperform the others. I will just be very surprised if it does, based on, you know, based on how much I've used these and I've done a lot of underwater tests and seen how they work. I will be very surprised if this one will outperform them enough to justify the added cost. But again, I can't claim anything for certain. And so if you've used, you know, this crab as well as the others, please do let us know. Let us know how you did. We're not going to take down any comments, whether they're overly good or overly bad. This is all about transparency. I just wanted to give this initial review to show the initial thoughts on checking out this crab for the first time. As I said before, once those sheep's heads start getting thick again, I'll tie this on, take it out, and then test it to see exactly how it performs compared to these others. So that's it for now. Thank you so much for your time and watching this video. And if you're new to Salt Strong, just know that we're the online fishing club that'll help you catch more inshore slams while saving money on all the tackle you need. To learn more, go to saltstrong.com. Otherwise, hope to see you again soon. There's something about the water that'll give you peace all by yourself or with your family. Live Salt Strong and wet a line today.